watch the moment a postman was thankfully saved after being pushed onto the underground tracks. Kurdish migrant Brashorsh shoved the victim, who he didn't at all know, onto the tracks on the 3rd of February. Shorsh denied trying to kill him in court, saying he did it as revenge, because the victim, a postman, had given him a dirty look. Then it emerged that Shorsh is a Kurdish migrant who had already been convicted of sex crimes and was facing deportation at the time of this senseless incident. The CCTV footage shows the postman victim on his way home from work, walking along the platform at Oxford Circus, when Shorsh jumped up and pushed him onto the tracks. The victim barely missed touching the live rail. Another passenger intervened to help him back up. The driver of the oncoming train told Inner London Crown Court, if he had been on the track a few seconds later, he would have been killed. The driver put on the emergency brake and his train was just 4 seconds away from striking the victim. Reiterating that he wanted revenge for an apparent dirty look, calling the victim disrespectful, Shorsh pleaded not guilty to the attempted murder charge and denied another count of attempted grievous bodily harm, but the jury decided he was guilty. Shorsh admitted that what he had done was scary. Asked why, he said, "He made me angry and I hated him." The judge noted that while the jury had been sent to consider its verdict, Shorsh had smiled the whole time in the dock, displaying a complete lack of remorse. The victim said he feared he would lose his life, adding, "I recognise that stopping a train is not like stopping a bike." Train driver Bobby Walker said in his statement he thought someone was about to commit suicide. He was leaning forward onto the track. "The male in the red jacket fell into the track, but not the deeper track area. I immediately put the train into emergency. I was shaken very badly by this. If he had been on the track a few seconds later, he would have been killed. Also, if I had looked away for a few seconds, he would have been killed. I am very glad I managed to stop the train." This conviction of attempted murder joins a roster of crimes committed by the migrant. He has a roll of convictions for assault and indecent acts since he came to the UK in 2019. The Home Office did try to deport him, but he lodged an appeal with the Immigration Tribunal, which meant he could stay in the UK. He attempted to kill the postman during this time. A source told The Sun, "It makes you wonder what exactly you have to do to be deported from the UK." By the time he had lodged his appeal, Shorsh had amassed 12 convictions for 21 offences, including assault and outraging public indecency. The Home Office declined to comment to The Sun. Just how someone with this record could still be in the UK prompts uncomfortable questions for authorities. Brits' anger has simmered over migration in recent months, as crimes committed by illegal immigrants or migrants with a strong track record of criminality inevitably could have been avoided had Britain's borders been secured. Labour had promised to get control of Britain's borders, but the numbers of small boat arrivals have soared since they took office. Ben Leo said migration to the UK was a national emergency when it emerged that more than 5,500 asylum seekers had arrived in the country on small boats in the 6 weeks since Labour had taken power.
It's been 6 weeks since Labour took government while pledging to end the small boats crisis. But tonight, I can exclusively reveal that after another bumper load of small boat channel crossings today, more than 5,500 illegal migrants have now arrived in Britain since Keir Starmer's government swept to power on July the 4th. At least 9 small boats made the perilous journey across the channel today, containing 450 undocumented migrants from the continent and beyond. The grim total for the year so far is 19,000. Let's be clear, we've no idea who these people are, where they came from, or what their intentions are while in Britain. So Keir Starmer, our Prime Minister, promised to smash the gangs by setting up a border command unit. He scrapped the Rwanda plan. He's allowed 100,000 illegal migrants to apply for asylum. And his deputy, Angela Rayner, has warned Brits that every borough in the UK must take their, quote, fair share of illegal migrants in their communities. This is a national emergency. The safety of our nation is at risk, and failure to get a grip of this crisis is only encouraging even more death and horror in the Channel. Tonight, I ask, does the government care? Does Sir Keir Starmer care? Is anyone listening? The country needs answers. Let's cross live now to GB News Home and Security Editor Mark White, who's been keeping tabs on today's grim milestone. Mark, this is a rather chilling development, I guess, since Labour took over. They promised to smash the gangs. They scrapped Rwanda. There's been nothing to replace it. And now today we hit 5,500 and 19,000 for the year. What's going on with our country, Mark?
Yes, sadly, it's not an unexpected development. If anything, actually, there are probably a slightly fewer coming across than we would have expected now that we're in the height of summer. But there have been some days where it's been a bit windy in the Channel, including this week. So I was in Dover earlier in the week on the clifftop there reporting on another milestone that 5,000 migrants had crossed the Channel illegally since Labour came to power. And then we had two or three days of windy weather, and it's only now this weekend that things have calmed down enough to allow more boats to come. And sure enough, we had just after 11 o'clock this morning, the Border Force vessel Ranger coming in with 50-odd migrants. It returned again with another 40 migrants. Then the Border Force vessel Defender was in as well with 135 migrants on board. And so it continued throughout the day with our producer down in Dover estimating that at least 9 small boats came into UK waters carrying more than 450 people, taking the total for the year to now more than 19,000, and of course that milestone as well to 5,500 since Labour came to power, promising to smash the gangs. They scrapped the Rwanda deal on the first day in office. It was, according to Sir Keir Starmer, a gimmick. Instead, what he wants to do is go after the people smugglers. But that's going to take some time. They haven't even managed to appoint a new senior officer in charge of this new border security command. And that's, what, over 6 weeks since Labour came to power. So they've got some way to go to achieve this goal of supposedly smashing the gangs. And while they don't do that, then all of the time when the weather improves, we'll get boat after boatload coming to the UK.
Mark, is this a national security risk? How does it present itself when it comes to the safety of our country and the great British public?
It's undoubtedly a national security risk. Security sources have told me in the past that they are very concerned that individuals with extremist links have undoubtedly crossed the English Channel, some they know about, others that they don't know about. And of course, add to that the process of throwing identity documents into the English Channel, as they're told to do by the people smuggling gangs. It makes identifying those individuals that much more difficult. And then just add the security concerns around the general tension that it's bringing to the nation. Now, the government, those in authority, don't like to talk about this in the wake of the riots that we've seen. But there is a correlation. There is a tension in communities right across the country by mass migration, but in particular by the illegal immigration across the Channel, by those then claiming asylum and being housed in hundreds of hotels right across the country. There is barely a community in the country that hasn't seen a local hotel requisitioned by the Home Office for use by migrants. And that brings with it tensions. And until that's properly addressed, those tensions are not going to be alleviated.
Keir Starmer's premiership may still be in its infancy, but it has already been marked by chaos and division. The Prime Minister's approval rating has tanked in recent days. 52% of Brits told YouGov Britain was headed in the wrong direction. Starmer's net favourability rating, the difference between those who favour him and those who oppose him, has dropped to zero, meaning the two camps are equal. Professor Matt Goodwin says immigration has become the top issue for voters in the UK, a development of which Keir Starmer might do well to take stock.
Immigration is now the number one issue in the country. So it's above the economy, it's above the NHS, it's above crime. That's a remarkable thing, given that we're in a very severe cost of living crisis. The NHS is collapsing and crime is visibly been bearing down on people. For the Brits to say, actually, no, immigration is my top concern, it gives you a sense of where the public mood is. And the other thing I would say is this weekend we got some other evidence from pollsters like Opinium 2, which not only show that Keir Starmer's leadership ratings have collapsed since the election last month, and they really have. I mean, his net leadership rating is down 26 points with that pollster. But they also asked Brits, well, what do you think about immigration today? 66% said immigration is too high. And then they were asked, well, what do you think about how immigration has impacted the economy, has impacted public services, and has impacted our cultural life? And a larger number of Brits said it's impacted those things negatively than the number who said it's impacted those things positively. So what I would argue is, the Brits are becoming more concerned about immigration. They're becoming more sceptical about immigration at exactly the same time as Labour are now pushing the pedal down on mass immigration.
Nicholas Dunning, GB News.